What are the risks of having both the COVID-19 infection and having a broken bone? As of today, April 15, 2020, the United States remains in a state of social distancing and business shutdown, except for essential services. Even elective surgery is not permitted in the state of Florida to save ventilators, medical equipment, and medical beds for potential COVID-19 infection patients. Only emergency surgeries for certain broken bones, nerve compressions, and infections are being performed by orthopedic surgeons. The effect of surgery on COVID-19 patients on an emergent basis is a significant concern. So far, much of that experience on treating broken bones on patients with COVID-19 pneumonia has been in China, as the pandemic experience is several months ahead of the United States. Orthopedic surgeons in Hubei province, China, have recently shared their results in caring for 10 COVID-19 patients with broken bones in the Journal of Bone and Joint Surgery Express publication. The lead author is Dr. Bobin. Of these 10 patients, 7 had broken hips, 2 broke their spine, and 1 broke the wrist. Before I review the Hubei experience, the viewers should know that large bone fractures such as broken hips and broken spines are already associated with breathing problems. There are 3 main reasons. Number 1, the breaks are very painful and limits the ability to sit up or mobilize, thus reduce breathing capacity. Number 2, patients are older, typically having broken bones because of osteoporosis and a generalized physical decline. Number 3, breaks of large bones can release fat droplets in the blood, which can then block the lung micropores, reducing the inflow of oxygen through your lungs. Even without the COVID-19 infection, these folks are already at a high risk of complications, poor outcomes, and even death. Yearly mortality rates for those with broken bones in the geriatric population is up to 35% in the first year. Unfortunately, the outcomes are even worse if you have the COVID-19 pneumonia. In the Hubei province experience, all 10 patients had CT scan evidence of the viral pneumonia. 6 of 10 had significant reduced lymph cells, which may indicate a response to an infection. 9 of 9 tested had high levels of serum D-dimer, indicating a clotting event. 9 of 9 tested had elevated C-reactive proteins, which indicated inflammation. Of these 10 fractured patients, 3 had surgery. 7 were deemed too sick to have an operation, or the doctors decided that non-surgical treatment was less risky. 4 patients died within 2 weeks of the admission. All 4 of these patients were older than 75 years of age. The remaining 6 patients' longer-term outcomes are yet to be determined. Most of the surviving patients were younger than 55 years old. At the time of publication, these patients were listed as remaining in the hospital. Please note that all patients received antibiotics and antiviral medications. In this very small sample size of patients, those over the age of 75 had a 66% mortality rate within 2 weeks of admission to the hospital. Of the 3 patients who had surgery, all for broken hips, 1 died. The authors of the paper did provide some standard suggestions about infection protocols, cautions on offering surgery, and the recommendation of a use of a negative pressure operating room. From my review of the limited data, the high mortality rates are associated with advanced age, concurrent medical issues such as respiratory disease, cirrhosis, and brain injury. Broken bones in those who have advanced age and in combination of medical conditions is already a very high-risk situation. With a COVID-19 pneumonia, the risk is compounded and the mortality rates are worse compared to the mortality rates without the virus. I know the sample size is very small, but the Hubei experience is very sobering. I share concerns for all patients who have COVID-19 infections and urge all to follow the health department recommendations of your local governments. I do not want to alarm you all. I just want to share the upcoming publication in the Journal of Bone and Joint Surgery about COVID-19 virus and fractures. Thank you for watching.